Hello everyone, this is Anubhati Devna, the trainee under Lexis & Company for the month of July. So as you have already watched the title below, what this video is all going to be about. So let's get started. Talking about this, what the case I'll talk about, this is the third most important case in IBC, if you just go through it. So it says that this case was filed because earlier in the case of Naeem Khan versus State 2013, the issue of acid attack under section 307 came into limelight when Lakshmi, a 16-year-old girl, was made a victim of an inhuman acid attack by the accused. So this case simply talks about this 16-year-old Lakshmi, who is an acid attack victim and who has been acid attacked by an accused. Acid attack in terms of motive and emotions is regarded as a crime of passion, which is fueled by revenge or jealousy. Because this is passion. Why? Because someone will not come up with the immediate incident of doing acid attack. It will get, acid attack cases are mostly seen by that they have grown jealousy, or they have grown revenge, they have grown anything that harmful, or they have planned it. That's why this is called the crime of passion. Means they have grown the passion of killing the other person, or damaging the other person rather than not killing. It is presumed to be done as throwing acid is an easy way of taking revenge from a woman by disfiguring her physical body for demands like sexual favors, marriage proposals and dowry demands. So mostly seen as proposals, when they have proposed someone and they have not said yes, simply acid attack. Now this have mostly seen for reasons like sexual proposals for marriage or for dowry demands. Now perpetrations of acid attacks by disfiguring and causing extreme physical and mental suffering to her victims fulfill their desires of revenge and jealousy. So how do they fulfill their revenge and jealousy? When they put the acid, they disfigure the person, and that's how they get enjoyment, or their relief or pleasure. Because disfiguring someone means they will not go to some other person. Their thinking is like that, they will not go to some other persons. They have got the triumph. Now that is what it is said. It is presumed to be done at throwing acid. The accused was held guilty and compensation to the victim was provided under section 357 subsection 1 subsection B by the physical and mental agony she would throw. So that's what actually the case says, that she was paid compensation. So the case of Lakshmi was filed to reimburse victims for their damages and help them get the required medical treatment. That is why it was said that the compensation was not only for the monetary compensation, but they will allow their treatment also. The punishment mentioned in the IPC is not enough for the victim to get justice, because the trauma and pain of the survivor are far greater. So yes, the rape victims, the acid attack victims, I feel these are the most dangerous things. And because they just don't even realize that they are not physically hampering, but they are emotionally hampering too. They are just not killing somebody. Killing is much more easy. They are taking someone's life, but also not taking it fully. That's like that. Means you are cutting the tree, but also not cutting the tree from the ground itself. You're just making it looking like a haunted tree. That's like. After being a victim to an acid attack herself, the victim Lakshmi filed a PIL in the Supreme Court. In response, now PIL is the litigation. In response to that PIL, a number of orders and directives were passed by the legislative and the Supreme Courts of India in the forms of guidelines of human provisions and redressals of such acid attack surveyors. The chances in the Indian jurisprudence range to various statutes and did not limit to IPC. Okay, this doesn't limit to IPC because it's a very dangerous thing. Movies have been done by famous actors like Deepika And there are many movies, there are many activists on these acid attack victims, and even there is a cafe in Mumbai that is only dedicated to the workers of this, only dedicated to acid attack victims, and they work, means the women over there work for their livelihood, they earn something in the cafe. That's what actually works, by just not the activists, what will they do? They will just fight for it. But what about their actual life? So that's what it is. So think practically about these things. Don't ever even think of taking revenge of someone like that. Take revenge on someone by being successful by yourself, not by hampering someone, or not by hampering yourself even. That's it. Thank you.